Hey YouTube family, how you guys doing? Hope this video is finding you all doing well. So welcome to something a little different. If you're looking for guitar mods and guitar sounds and some upgrades like I normally do in my videos, you might want to just skip this one. So let me explain. There's a ton of stuff that I like. Really, outside of my family, my wife, kids, you know, my immediate family, my friends, relatives. There's really only two things that I'm truly passionate about. You know, stuff that I think about every single day. And that is guitars and music and exercise. And the latter is what allows me to do the former. So many people I talk to take their health for granted. And to me, I've come to realize that most of us, we don't worry about problems until there's a problem that we have to worry about. But I've always been kind of in the mindset that why wait for a problem if you can prevent one from happening? So today I'm going to take you on a little kind of exercise journey. I'm just going to show you some of the things that I do that allow me to be able to do this stuff every weekend. Here, let me explain a little more. All right, so every weekend, my band plays. I have to pick one of these guitars, right? Oh, hard life. I am blessed that I get to play every weekend. I get to pick one of these guitars, right? Actually, there's a few more in some cases around here too. Load it up in a case. I have to come in here. Oh, there's another guitar. And those are some empty cases, so don't freak out. Those aren't full. But then I gotta grab this 30-pound amp, or I might decide to go with my 212 cab, which is, you know, 50 pounds. Then I got to pick, you know, either this pedal board, which I usually take to small gigs, or this bigger one. Sometimes I'll bring an extension cab. And then my hardware box comes with me. Like, I can literally do guitar repairs with that box. I got everything in there, from cables to tools to, you know, extra mics to guitar stands, you name it, it's in there. I always bring it with me. This is almost 30 pounds as well. And then I gotta carry all that stuff up these stairs, right? And then outside, of course. And then into my big blue Nissan Titan, which has a 5.5-inch lift. So this tailgate goes up to my rib cage. All right, we are like high off the ground. So you guys are like, what's your point? I don't get it. So the point is, if I have a show that starts at 9:30 or 10 o'clock, then those events, loading the truck, something as simple as doing that, starts at 7 p.m. And then I got to do this. I got to go in the shed. Don't mind the mess in here. Haven't done my spring cleaning yet. I got to grab that cable box. Believe it or not, that sucker weighs 100 pounds. It is full to the brim with cables and power cords and monitor wedges. You name it, it's in there. So I got to take that. I got to take that 80-pound QSC sub. I got to take these two 50-pound bottom end speakers. Those two towers, which are pretty light, monitors. Our lights, these light poles, you know, my mic stand, and all that stuff has to be put into my lifted truck. So then you got to go to the gig, unload all that stuff, set it up, right? That's the work. Then you get to play your guitar with your friends, you know, your bandmates, for 3 hours, sometimes 4 hours, depending on the gig that we have. And then at 1 in the morning, or 2 in the morning, you get to tear all that stuff down again, load it all back up in the truck, drive home. So then you're 3 o'clock in the morning, pushing maybe 3:30 a.m. And here, although we live in a nice community, the people are great, you can't leave stuff in your truck. You know, you just never know anymore. There's a lot of people out there that like to acquire things without working for them. Anyway, so then I gotta unload all that stuff again, right? Put everything in the shed, you know, like it's all here, and bring everything downstairs, and then go to bed, and then get up in the morning, and, you know, take care of the kids and the house stuff, and you gotta just keep moving, right? A lot of people don't realize, but your health and your body is what allows you to do that. If you're watching this video, you're passionate about guitars just like I am. And the thing that allows us to chase that passion is, in fact, our physical and mental health. If you lose that, it doesn't matter what you're passionate about. That all goes with it, right? I'm just going to show you a few things that I do to maintain my health and fitness. And I don't like spending money for it either. Yeah, so I'm not spending, you know, $800 or $1,000 a year on a gym membership. You know how many budget guitars I can buy for that? So no, I don't do that. Once in a while, I'll go to a gym. You know, I get a day pass or a week pass if I want to lift some weights or whatever. But mostly, I like doing stuff that my body can do on its own. So first off, we start with the 1K run. Now that we're warmed up, it's time for some exercise. That's the gist of it. So four rounds, done. 20, 25 minutes. And it's the heart pumping for sure. And it's not about, oh, well, I could never do those exercises and blah, blah, blah. You just, it's like anything, you work your way up to it, right? When you practice the guitar, certain things you can't do. And then with time and with, you know, dedicated practice and determination, you up the antics a little bit, right? What you're normally practicing gets easy, so then you practice something harder. Same with that. I've been working at that stuff for years, right? Because I realized the long-term benefits of it. I'm 53 and I'm not getting any younger, and it's not getting any easier. You take whatever you can do and you just do that a little more intensely than you would when you're doing it on a daily basis, so that you don't spend more time at it. You just make it more intense so the time can be shorter and you still get more out of it. So then your daily chores become easy compared to the extra effort that you're conditioning your body to endure. So that's what I attribute my ability to gig till 2 a.m. in the morning, come home, you know, get 3-4 hours sleep, still be functional, and, you know, be able to take care of all my responsibilities and just be able to do it again. It's the whole health part, guys and girls. That's the key. So if you guys like doing that, make sure you don't forget about this, because when this goes, that goes. Right? All that stuff outside allows me to do all of this stuff inside.